would start with a poem that actually wasn't mine that I read for the first time last week in class, because caring is sharing and it's cool. But you can give me like the gladiator, like if that's cool or not. Yeah? Okay. All right. This is called Degrees of Grey in Phillipsburg by Richard Hugo. You might come here Sunday on a whim. Say your life broke down. The last good kiss you had was years ago. You walk these streets laid out by the insane, past hotels that didn't last, bars that did, the tortured try of local drivers to accelerate their lives. Only churches are kept up. The jail turned 70 this year. The only prisoner is always in, not knowing what he's done. The principal supporting business now is rage, hatred of the various grades, the mountain sins, hatred of the mill, the silver bill repeal, the best liked girls who leave each year for view. One good restaurant and bars can't wipe the boredom out. The 1907 boom, 8 going silver mines, a dance floor built on springs. All memory resolves itself in gaze. In panoramic green, you know the cattle eat. For 2 stacks high above the town, 2 dead kilns, the huge mill in collapse. For 50 years, that won't fall finally down. Isn't this your life? That ancient kiss still burning out your eyes? Isn't this defeat so accurate? The church bell simply seems a pure announcement. Ring and no one comes. Don't empty houses ring? Are magnesium and scorn sufficient to support a town? Not just Phillipsburg, but towns of towering blondes, good jazz and booze. The world will never let you have until the town you came from dies inside. Say no to yourself, the old man, 20 when the jail was built, still laughs although his lips collapse. Someday soon, he says, I'll go to sleep and not wake up. You tell him no. You're talking to yourself. The car that brought you here still runs. The money you buy lunch with, no matter where it's mined, is silver. And the girl who serves your food is slender, and her red hair lights the wall. Oh, that's I now realize that was a terrible idea to now go to my poetry, but. So this one, I just wrote the next 2 poems this week on a plane, actually. So this next poem I just wrote this week, and it's called Valentine's. 9:33 a.m. Arrived 12 minutes earlier than your 15-minute early goal. Yes, a spot. You've got it together today. They'll think you've got it together. The spot's by a McDonald's drive-in. It's a real spot, but you see why it's open. A little too close to the driveway. Getting sideswiped, the nightmare you can't add. Smart people pass this up. They can't take the bad spots. They sleep. They have confidence to walk in a few minutes late. There's enough time to find another spot. 9:34 a.m. Pace up and down and around the car. Wince when cars get too close. There's an urgency on the way to McMuffins. You should move. You should move the car for peace of mind. It's not too late to move the car. Have faith you found this spot. It's not too late to move the car. You have an appointment. You shouldn't make them wait. 9:38 a.m., leave car. 9:42 a.m., walk back in pace. 2-step turn back to the bumper. Clench your stomach and turn towards the drug and alcohol intake on Fillmore. Cross. Take note of how much you don't like this street and can't come back. Open the clinic door with your sleeve. This is the responsible thing to do. Both your therapists say so. It's probably situational, probably, but 9:43 a.m., open the door to the roar of dirty tiled floors, hot candy breath and sanitizer. Fidgeting hands and elevated tone-deaf greetings. The air doesn't move. You were too honest. That's why you're here. No one checks the correct boxes on health intake forms. 9:55 a.m. The first counselor wishes you a happy Valentine's Day. You have to recall the last 30 days that passed without a drink. It's been almost a year without a daily drink. Rarely was it a drink. Today is Fat Tuesday. There are ways to count ounces in drinks. Binging is a cruel imperial chart. Were you abused? Always the oddest query. Do you know what that means? Perspective makes it an impossible question. Recalibration says, don't be dramatic. 10:13 a.m., you're led. Told to leave your purse on the chair, the nurse will watch. The bathroom has no sink. You can't be trusted with water. You can't be trusted. You step outside and ask where you can wash your hands. There's a sink in the hallway. You wash in front of an awake sleeping man you saw earlier. He's hunched in a chair. His heart rate is seductive. You count breaths every 11 seconds. You haven't slept in days. You're asked if it's okay to be weighed. You say no, it's only blood you're offering. Takes a sip of blood. This next one is called Want by MTV. More than AIDS, Arthur Ashe said his true burden was being black. CC DeVille said being junky was sexier than being fat. Everything I know I learned from TV. So my narration is jerky, maybe sometimes unreliable. I know Madonna said power is being told you're not loved and undesirable and not being destroyed between commercial breaks. The Disappeared. I lost a 66-pound brown girl. They get lost all the time. She wasn't misplaced, but neglected. Well-nourished, but detested. No social media whistles when she vanished. A Weight Watchers key, new wardrobe. I was sick of hiding her. She was sick of fighting, sharing house with all the spite. Jane Cookie Dough, maybe. The pockmarked unnamed grave. A seared red box of suffocated flames. Her wake, flaccid flesh and burnt armor. Nights of shining inertia. Her phantom limbs still ignite, but I count and remember. Count and run her down. Count and run her back into the ground. Push notifications. I haven't slept well since. It can't be counted in linear. Not a measure, more a mark. The rewinding, this same part. The restless, the slips, a faded fluidity into these concrete times to disembody. And this next one is called Beloved, and there are some lines lifted straight from the Toni Morrison novel. More than Pop-Tarts, Bruce Banner, my mom's quick wit was our shared triumph. Her beam still fighting, still light irises, the color of her skin. Hearing her ignite through the voice of her dog, a sponge weathering the waves of the strange hiding meat he obediently observed. Her banter, her barking, her delight in playing ventriloquist lulled us. More than the smell of blood, peroxide falling off my dusty pink Mrs. Pac-Man skateboard, the scent of soreness from laughter, my grounding. I didn't know how much the scars would count, how age would become collage. Without the speckled blood pavement, I could scrape the white off my fingernails, connect the dots on. How I'd mourn the dog she had to forget she buried, because it was an accident, because of her baby brother, who fought the hallucinations. Scarlet scenes, a beloved, too precious for this world, sans small peach pills. How I'd mourn all she surrendered, boxed in wood, under red clay, caked in cryonic fear, when she buried her mother the coming year. The interruption was simple, a paw wound for tending, small licks needing cleansing. A stove pot toppled over, a house left bare bone. The smell of boiled fur hanging, I still remember. How the most innocent suffered the most cruelty. I learned, she turned to pray. For her, the specifics melted away and hid in the merciful wings of dismemory, running, panning out, painting a sigh, tasting a glance, she used to be able to do that. But survival required broad strokes, with the new slits of irons framing her nose, balancing the weight. My nascent compass, struggling to stand straight. The Late Bloom. Cocoons for months, years. Decades I wish I'd slept through entirely, or cherry-picked days to pull out and play, maybe just honey lacquered hours. And I was gonna close with one other poem by someone who I've read a lot, Reginald Shepherd, who I love so much. And this one is called Johnny Minotaur. This morning we can be kind to one another, a trophy carried through the labyrinth in the arms of a blind minotaur. You're wholly occupied by pastimes of invisibility. Enchanted, I said once, you smirked. taking the hand of difference, taken in by what the retina takes in. Sullen boy, sight sullies you. It's made you what you are. I prefer to watch you sleep, your face adorned by lack. Your person sacrificed to first light slatted through matte blinds. I'm not ready to give that up just yet, the giving everything for what the eye can see, for nothing, not free. I'm partial to the part of light that scribbles on your cheek. Your sleep finds me stealing kisses from particulars, sight unseen. A parcel of you you can't keep, I'll carry from your room, untouched by human hands. The men you've rejected will be in the bushes tonight, searching for a shadow that looks like you. Sing them a lullaby to leave them out with your amazing voice, but don't wake up.